on this map.
So there you go. You've been told, teams. You've been told, step up your game. Speaking of the game, we've got a full complement of players on the server, so I think we're going to quickly jump on to it just to see the bit of the warm-up while we do our analysis and bring you the roster rundown and whatnot. So thanks a lot, analysis team. See you soon, no doubt. So thanks a lot to Jay and War Clown. Yep, we're exchanging some HFs, HFs. Have fun. It's certainly been a lot of fun to cast this game. It's actually been an enjoyable one. So let's see.
And how the decoy grenades on the knife round.
Yeah, it's the decoy grenades in the knife round again. And all the shanks going in. This one being played fast. There's no keen French strats here on this round. Shanks, ahoy. Looks like VERYGAMES have got the edge here. They've got the advantage in terms of numbers. And Nilla's going to level it out, make that another one. So the Danes, while all the decoy grenades going down, have managed to pull that back and win. But again, knife round kind of irrelevant on this map. It's pretty well balanced.
Yeah, for sure. Of all the maps, I think it's just two that the knife round is least important because it's a team map, but you can still rack up round us.
Yeah, I was going to say, it's a team map, but it's just a team map, isn't it? So
yeah, exactly.
So we're waiting for the guys to ready up again, just to, for those who have joined us for the third map, this is in a best of three. VERYGAMES took Nuke, which was the second map, but ANEXIS had already taken the first map, which was the Inferno. Been pretty close games, I kind of guess, although the second round score was 16-9, so maybe not that close for VERYGAMES. But ultimately, this is the deciding map. It's going to see who goes through and who goes home. So, pistol round coming in. We'll see how they're measuring up. And look at this from ANEXIS, going pretty aggressive. At long, and it looks like they might have already got someone in the pit, by the way, so wonder if that'll come into play at some point in the game.
And they have three guides towards the stairs area here, so or a short area, so I think actually ANEXIS might be walking to a trap, but just as I say that, the bomb is walking down towards middle, so maybe they're going towards B. It's kind of hard to say at this point.
Well, with MSL being in the pit, the suggestion would be then they might be doing some kind of split, and MSL's there, kind of act as a scout, but also as well a jack in the box. And yeah, it looks like we have got this split coming in. They're going up catwalk, but as you say, VERYGAMES have stacked this. They're going to walk into it. It's going to be pretty horrible. And yeah, there's one death, but they've answered back immediately. Glaive answering back for MBK's kill with a kill onto Smiths, who played so well in the previous map. Now ANEXIS are committing to it fully. This is a peak. MSL is going to get that kill there, but Existence is going to answer back. And all of a sudden, VERYGAMES are all there. MSL, it's time to do your jack-in-the-box thing, but he's going to get absolutely rinsed along. But Glaive has picked up two kills, and Kenny S throws that nade in to destroy that numerical advantage. Glaive doing a Usain Bolt with the bomb. He knows that VERYGAMES are all on A. This is going to be a free and easy plant. 15 seconds on the clock. Glaive already got three kills. Huge round for him. Definitely going to get the plant. Nothing Kenny S can do about it, but as you can see, the blue outline means he's going to get there soon. Glaive not able to get into a good position. It's all on this shot now. It is the battle of pistols. Kenny S has already got two kills. Glaive has managed to back off. Of course, he's very low HP, 14 HP here, and backing at this position might just be playing into Kenny S's hands. It certainly is. Kenny S straight on the defuse. He didn't buy that it was a fake. Kenny S is going to get the kill to add insult to injury. And in the end, VERYGAMES probably just about played that right.
Yeah, it was a very back and forth pistol round. Stacking catwalk with three guys, it's still very hard since the Glock is so powerful, I would say, but yeah, really it came down to that one-on-one situation between Kenny S and that other guy, but Kenny S playing smart, holding the defuse, even though I think the terrorist made the right decision not peeking since he only had 14 HP.
Yeah, and that was the thing. It was one of those damned if you do, damned if you don't thing. If you peek, people say, why didn't you hide? If you hide and you stay on the defuse, how can you get caught out by a non-fake defuse?
Rock, paper, scissors, I would
say. Yeah, exactly. There's no real way to win it. You can't be too harsh on them. Scream just exercising a bit of a headshot-only deathmatch there on these on this eco run to make it 2-0 to VERYGAMES. And it's a good start. It's a start VERYGAMES will want. ANEXIS won't be too worried at this stage, but you can see, thanks to the plant, here come the AKs, so we will definitely give this round some full commentary. Let's see what they're doing. They're going to spam those doors as they cross over. Don't do any damage, but they're pretty much spreading out in a standard, almost like an anti-eco set.
It is an anti. Oh, but they bought, yeah.
Yeah, that's the thing. It's the Nexus have set up almost as if they're playing an anti-eco. It's
okay, now I understand what you mean.
They've spread out across the map, and they just seem to be waiting for any Verygames pushes, but obviously Verygames aren't going to be doing any pushes, but they will know that ANEXIS have bought the guns because they've spammed through the doors, and you know, you probably would buy the guns again. You can afford to with a plant. You can see MSL has got a Galil, but the rest have a full complement of AKs. So, slow round. No action to speak of as yet, but that's going to change while ANEXIS start moving up short. Great headshot from Glaive. He started this game very strong. And if they get a second here, which they do, well, Existence is going to answer one back, but it is still going to give them that advantage. 4-on-3 now, and the bomb going down screen still at long. So MSL is going to get taken off screen, but Existence, that's brilliant play from Existence to get that double. 2v2. Kenny is spamming away in mid. You can see how low Pimp is. You can see Glaive really needs to do it, and Glaive has done it. Got that headshot on Kenny S to put the ball very much in ANEXIS's court, but only just. Pimp on a life support machine, just kind of warping around on 3 HP. What's he going to be able to do? But Existence, who's already got 3 kills this round in the pit, he's been in this position a billion times before. It's completely advantageous. He knows he's got the bomb. They haven't even got time to get him planted. They're going to have to kill him. And in the end, Pimp's going to do it with 3 HP. And they clutch around there out of nowhere.
Yeah, I actually think Existence played way too passive there. He should have just challenged the guy at long or challenged someone. I mean, like, your advantage is when you peek towards long, not when you hide deep inside the pit. So, kind of strange decision, but great round for ANEXIS.
Well, definitely a great round for ANEXIS, but what I will say as well about that round is, do you think that Existence, with all the criticism he's got about being a weak link, do you think what he didn't want to do there was peek and die and have everyone, you know, talking about, oh, why did he peek, why did he peek? You know, I mean, those things probably do start to play on your mind.
I mean, they should be experienced players who don't care about comments, but who knows? It can sting sometimes when people write bad stuff.
There's nowhere to hide from it in the Counter-Strike community. There's many an avenue you can stroll down straight into a brick wall of flame, and even the elite players like Existence not protected from it. There's no one spared the wrath of the Counter-Strike community. So, ANEXIS, do break the cycle, pick up that round. That's going to give them lots of confidence. But while that happens, Existence, the man we've just been talking about, going to exercise an AWP kill. And see, this is more like the old Existence. This is like what he used to do back in the day when he would play these positions with an AWP. Nico's just going to run around, crab claw him. A great communication from ANEXIS. But a lot of early kills from Verygames. Smith's down in CT spawn, spraying away with his M4. And I don't know, it looks like we might be seeing a save here because ANEXIS have got this bomb down. Nico made 2 kills. Glaive having a great game. Knows that there's one there jumping in the smoke. And no, they are going to go for it, Verygames. And they're going to get 1 kill. So Glaive's been taken out of this round. Nilla's going to take down Kenny S. Kenny S is on the site, and it's Nico that's at long. Sorry, having an absolute meltdown there. And in the end, Nico is going to get the AWP through the smoke to make it 2-for-2. Were you surprised at a 2v3 situation there that they decided to try and go for the defuse?
I don't know, really. I mean, they might have went because of they might have tried because they had an advantage in the beginning of the round. They're just like, oh, we can't lose this round. But I think they just should have saved the AKs, as you say.
And that's quite common on the DDoS 2, actually, like
see to get 2 entry frags and then the round just turns around in 1 second.
Yeah.
And it's basically because if you get split on A, I mean, you can get 2 early frags, but if the terrorists come from both ways, you're basically done.
So it's now a eco for Verygames, and we're not seeing anything special. There's no real stacks or anything, although they haven't crossed B. So they're playing it as a retake, and then they are crossing over now belatedly. But of course, ANEXIS have set up just perfectly for this anti-eco and haven't been caught out at all. And again, good discipline from the Danes. Easy to go gung-ho.
Yeah, just a standard anti-eco. This should be a really easy round for
Well,
ANEXIS.
Yeah, definitely. ANEXIS have managed to get up short. They've forced another game to push back, but Existence. He's having a pretty good game, it's got to be said, actually. Whatever you think of that season in the pit, Gets a kill. MSL answers back with a double while Smith picks up another one. MSL's going to go for the plant. Knows there's no one at long, so he knows it's safe to go for the long plant. And, of course, with it being an eco and them having the rifles, the distance definitely plays into their favor. You can see MSL's going to get another kill in this round. Three kills for him along with the bomb plant. Having a great round. Is he about to make it four? Just holding that area now. You can see Nico with the AWP managed to get himself into the pit. So this round is a certainty. Scream and Kenny S have got full HP. It is a 3v2 situation, but no way they can do anything about this. So they're just going to play for exits.
Yeah, and the great eco round, however, from VERYGAMES. I actually think people underestimate how important two frags can be, because if you look in T-Spawn right now, I think they are forced to drop two AKs and they have to buy new gear, so basically it can force the terrorist or this or the counter-terrorist to another eco, which basically means you have one round for just getting those two exit frags on an eco.
Yeah. Well, let's have a quick look at the frag charts, just what we're going at this next round, just quickly. Glaive, no surprises there, 7-4 for Anexis Existence though, 7-4 as well for VERYGAMES. So, both of those players carrying their respective flags, and Anexis going to be feeling pretty good about themselves at the moment. But as Bjorn, my colleague, has pointed out, absolutely vital to get those kills, and they can get onto A site here, but of course, VERYGAMES have got people positioned at long. You can see Scream's on B just watching for the mid push, so they're pretty confident that there's no one in those upper B tunnels. Glaive just trying to get an advantageous pick, just using the box. He's going to throw some nades in, throw some flashes in. They're going to drop back on short. The moment they're all bunched up a little bit, but there's not a VERYGAMES player to be seen. But VERYGAMES are playing very loose around the edges of Anexis. They're not looking to put the pressure on. Existence is able to get himself into a good position while Anexis are worried about perhaps the wraparound frag, and he's going to get a nade in there. That's going to do a little bit of damage. In the meantime, though, Kenny S and Scream not moving, even though they haven't seen one of the terrorists yet. They're still holding B. They've still got both of them on there. And in the end, it is going to be a short push. I'm guessing 30 seconds left. They're going to have to commit to it. Existence is shooting the boxes, though, to his advantage. He's going to be able to pick off one before a nade comes in and takes him down. So he's done his work there. He's stalled them for certain. Smith has dropped down into spawn again. And here come the cavalry for VERYGAMES. 4-on-4. Pimps is going to get a kill. You can see Smith is going to answer back as well. MSL just used the angle to his advantage, but in the end that means nothing to Kenny S. But then Glaive's going to answer back. It's a very close round. MBK with another kill. You can see that Pimp.
Time's running out.
Yeah, they know where Pimp is and time's going to run out. And MBK again, super smart. Just knew the time was going to run out. They knew Pimp wasn't anywhere in a position to be able to get there and plant the bomb. And it's 3-on-3 in Anexis. All that stalling on short is what eventually cost them the round there.
Yeah, for sure. And I really thought they had the round when they had short, especially they had all the map control in the world as well, as we talked about earlier. And as you said, they had the two guys defending B, and you're pushing out four guys short. You really should win that round.
Yeah, totally. I think Anexis will be kicking themselves a little bit about that, because 3-all and 4-2 within the context of a game, it might sound like just numbers on a board, but there's the money factor, the momentum factor. There's lots to consider in Counter-Strike. So definitely surrendering a round that you should win like that, it'll be in the back of their minds in this round. And this is usually when you see teams kind of falter. They are unable to put things out of their head. And here they are playing a very slow round. There's no fluid tactics here. They're not being bold. They're just thinking, we can't afford to lose this round. We can't afford to surrender momentum to VERYGAMES. They're about to push out at long, and MSL's smart enough to check that corner. He's going to get a kill on MBK. Now they're going to push him short. So MSL again with a kill, and this is a great textbook split. You can see the VERYGAMES Molotov just evaporating there. Bomb is being passed through to Glaive. No smoke for the crossover. It fell a little bit short by the looks of things, but that's not going to stop them get the bomb across. And Pimp is going to get the plant. So VERYGAMES, as it stands, going to try and get a couple of kills here. Kenny S is going to do it. That's going to give his position away. But it's going to make perhaps...
He should just back away now. Yeah. I mean, they really need those three weapons. If they can keep three weapons, this is actually that big a deal
for
them.
Glaive's the man who's bold enough to peek. But as you can see from the blue outline, oh, and that's a nice little headshot through the door. He went as well for another spam behind it. So he knows that there's the likelihood someone else is out there, but doesn't know who. You saw MSL's aim just jump up at the crucial moment. They wasn't able to get the headshot. And in the end, Glaive's going to get taken down as well. And the bomb's going to go off to make it 4-3 for Anexis. But VERYGAMES, although they lost a round, they did manage to get a few exit kills.
Yeah, for sure. And let's see if they have good economy? No, it seems like they have just two P250s and one Famos and one AK now.
Yeah, well...
No, they decided to buy it very, very late, actually.
Yeah, well, it's strange. It's actually, it looks like they're going to try and double up and go rifle, pistol, and maybe have the Famos in mid.
And
maybe
they're making the complete right decision, stacking three guys B. Like, this is a common thing, actually, in one at least in 1.6, where you buy when you have low money, and then you stack, let's say, for example, B. Because even if they don't go B, you can just save your weapons. So you can save them for next round.
Yeah.
It's kind of a good strategy, actually. The only thing that's not that good is that you will have a Famas and P250s on a real weapon round.
Well, it's playing the percentage.
Yeah.
So, ANEXIS at the moment, though, it's interesting. We've talked about their aggressive play. They're being very methodical here, and it's paying off. Nico making some ridiculous kill and then committing suicide in the end. So we've seen some true comedy from both of these teams over the course of the game. In the end, MSL is going to be able to bail out his teammate out of a hole while Nilla gets taken down by Smith, who's taking up a good position in lower. Kenny S is going to be putting down a smoke in the mid, and then he's going to get a door spam there. Great comms from the other player, MBK, it was, who's backing off to say he's on the door, spam him. So there's now a 1v2 situation for MSL, who's already got two frags here, playing very well, and Verygames is going to be wrapping around. Using that numerical advantage, bomb has gone down.
Good decision going both from the short here. I actually think Verygames will win.
Well, let's see. The flash is coming in. MSL, yep, you're absolutely spot on there. In the end, MSL didn't know where to shoot, didn't do a whole lot of much, didn't even really do that much damage to MBK. The flashes and smokes obviously playing a factor in. Verygames is going to come in and get this defuse, and that's going to make it a tight game.
Yeah, really close game here, though I would say it's quite heavily in favor of Verygames right now. They just look stronger, and they have an even score as CT, so advantage
think
for
Verygames. I definitely think at the moment what we're seeing is maybe not so much individual strength, although Kenny S is certainly catching my eye at the moment with a couple of shots in existence, often perceived to be the weak link in the chain, is having a good game. But I think what's interesting to note is that I still think ANEXIS are maybe having the better individual aim, but Verygames are really outbraining ANEXIS at the moment in the way they're playing CT.
Yeah, absolutely, especially in the team play area, clutching all those off-the-plan situations. And we actually see an eco now from ANEXIS, so Verygames may very well perhaps go into the lead on this half.
I definitely think that'll be happening, and while it's an eco, good opportunity to have a look at the frag charge. You see Kenny S jumping up on 7-4, and MSL has gone past his colleagues on 11-7. He's had a good few rounds. Well, ANEXIS, in the meantime, we're going to get an eco push from mid to B, and they're going to get one kill thanks to MSL. He's highlighting there in the score chart. Smith and existence doing work on B, bomb sighting in the end. Yep, they are going to keep it out. Screen getting in on the action. 5-4. So we've been talking about Verygames and how they're outbraining ANEXIS. What is it tactically that you feel ANEXIS aren't doing enough of? Like, what can ANEXIS do at this stage to pick up more T rounds against this particular Verygames CT setup?
I would say go for a B split, since that's, at least in 1.6, was the best counter to playing defensive on A. Basically, when you smoke CT spawn, you cut off the backup from A, and since there's probably one or two guys at a long pit, that's like the furthest away on the map you can be from B, so I would say they would should try a B split, or at least going towards B.
Yeah, well, definitely. Would concur with that, especially as it seems that Verygames are playing mids as well in an almost very passive manner.
Yeah, for sure.
But it's another slow round, guys. Nico's going to get that pick on existence. That's what Nico needs. His confidence probably be a little bit shot from losing all those duels with Kenny S in the last map on Nuke, but confidence will soon be regained if he keeps making shots like that. You can see that's allowed ANEXIS to get out at long. They're getting in the pit, and now we are going to see some sort of A split. I'm pretty sure you can see Pimp's going to get a kill. Scream's going to answer back with one, and now Glaive coming around. He knows that there's one there. He's trying to just peek and spam. He is going to get the headshot in the end, and MBK is going to get the revenge frag. 3-2 now for ANEXIS. They're pushing up long. They're using that smoke. They need to get this next kill. The flash certainly isn't going to facilitate that. MSL, though, we know what he's been capable of. Certainly this map looking very, very sharp. MBK, though, able to push in. He's reducing that distance and getting closer, but in the end, MSL doesn't care. He is going to get the kill, and Nico at long with the AWP is going to tie it up at 5-5, and that was a much, much better round from ANEXIS.
Yeah, for sure. Even though they went A and didn't go B as we thought they should go, and They did manage to get that entry frag from Nico. Great play from him.
That was the key to that round.
Yeah, for sure. And yeah. It's kind of weird Existence didn't kill him, because Existence were in the angle before him, and it's very rarely you see someone challenge an AWP that's already in an angle and win the duel.
Well, I think, you know, the team are going to need Nico to really step it up just while this eco is going on. I mean, Nico has had flashes of brilliance. I thought he was good on Inferno. I thought he played incredibly well there. I thought far less so on Nuke, where he seemed to be a bit dominated by Kenny S and didn't really have any joy going outside. And the AWP was effectively just a waste of money, as we highlighted. But I think what they really need him to step up on Dust2. Dust2 is a map where your AWPer can get entry picks as terrorist, and he can really roll out the red carpet for you to get on the bomb sites.
Yeah, for sure. And let's see what happens here. This is a really, really important round for, because I feel like ANEXIS will need at least 8 or 9 rounds this half. So.
Oh yeah, I definitely agree with that.
And we see that VERYGAMES has changed their play, going aggressive short. First round they do that, they have gone aggressive long every single round. all the other rounds.
Yeah. And, well, look at the way they're spread out. Very passive on B, very passive on A. They've got a stack on short, and I guess after you've just lost a round to an A split, that might be an interesting counter. Certainly in ANEXIS, when they found a strat that works, they've done it in clusters over the course of the game.
But and they're actually going for that B split now, but yeah, bad luck for them that they're aggressive on short this round.
I know, I was going to say, a round too late. Glaive, though, does get that entry pick in the mid, which is going to make this B split a lot easier, and VERYGAMES are going to be far, far away from the action. But MBK and Kenny S putting the ball back into VERYGAMES' court. Existence is going to do the flash over the top, and he's going to go fast, mega aggressive. Great kill from him, made that a great double. Brilliant play from Existence, rolling back the years there, and it's all on nil if it's a 1v2 situation. What's he going to be able to do? Is he going to, well, he's going to get the bomb, he's going to get the plant, and he's having to do a safe plant, though, because he's not sure of the CT positioning, and that could play a factor as well. He's going to get shot from Tunnel. He's expecting the other guy to be closer than he is, and as it turns out, it wasn't a very well-coordinated push from VERYGAMES. The fact that Nilla was expecting it to be is what cost him the round, but they're not going to care, VERYGAMES. They're going to be back 6-for-6, back on level terms, and again, I thought tactically, actually, ANEXIS, we've not given them credit for the tactics, but I thought tactically they executed that quite well.
Yeah, great, great decision, great execution, but kind of bad luck that this was the first round VERYGAMES was aggressive short, and of course if you're aggressive short you can easily just jump in the back of those players going out middle.
Right, well, it's been a close game, and you heard the thoughts of Bjorn, who certainly knows a thing or two about the game, there's no doubt about that. He feels that ANEXIS are going to have to get 8 or 9 rounds. They're on 6 at the moment. It's 6-for-6, there's only 3 left, so we need to see a big swing, a bit of momentum, a final push from ANEXIS if Bjorn's thoughts are to be correct. But at the moment, VERYGAMES have read the situation well. But Pimp, who managed to get into the pit, catches one off guard. Another headshot for him. A nice double at long. And Pimp's gone quiet this last kind of map and a half. But what a time to come alive. Jumping out of the pit like a jack in the box and getting 2 kills. Glaive's going to get another. Kenny S is going to come into mid. Take down MSL. Nilla's going to answer back. And all of a sudden, Kenny S is the last man standing for VERYGAMES. Don't think he's going to go for this. 1-against-4 with a clutch. And even though ANEXIS is a low HP, probably is going to see Kenny S run away and save his gun.
Yeah, great idea though for VERYGAMES pushing long late in the round. I mean, that's a very good move to do if there's not a T hidden in the big pit. And this round, kind of a bad luck that Pimp was sitting there and he got 2 easy frags.
Yeah, I think what's probably happened is because of the way they've been playing long, they've played it passive quite a lot of the time, they've probably not seen that ANEXIS have been pushing somebody along and getting somebody in the pit. And if they can do that, they can then make a decision whether or not to do an A split. So they probably weren't aware of that until now. I'm sure it's going to be on their mind, but sadly, there's not really a lot of the half left for them to assimilate this information. So 7-6 for ANEXIS. Quickly on the frag chart, look at Glaive bouncing back, 15-10. Kenny S, it's actually pretty even Stevens, all the frags for VERYGAMES. Kenny S just at the top, but everyone else playing their part, no doubt about that. So ANEXIS spreading out across the map. And you can see again, it looks like we've got 3 of VERYGAMES pushing through B tunnels, dropping down into lower. Nilla's going to get one. Wasn't expecting the other one to be there. So this is on this eco round that we've got from VERYGAMES. Kenny S is going to get the headshot. ANEXIS, though, are going to use that information and be like, okay, they're pushing through B. Let's just get up there. There is one on that site. Will they think to check? MBK's hiding. And in the end, yeah, not a lot he can do from there. MSL with the kill. Screams managed to pick up an AK. Wasn't able to get the headshot at distance. Probably just going to save this weapon as the smart play. And this should be ANEXIS's round. So they've managed to make it to the fabled 8 rounds, I'd say, beyond barring some sort of ridiculous disaster.
Yeah, and right now this game is impossible to call. I mean, both teams are one map each, and the score is going to be either 8-7 or 9-6 on DDoS 2. It's anyone's game still.
And you saw MSL just having a last minute, you know, what? Maybe I should check this corner before I drop down. And it turned out to be a sage decision from the young Dane. Glaive about to get a face full of bullets from Scream. And that's a nice little exit frag, but it's not going to change the fact that here we are on 8-4-6 to ANEXIS. So the Dane's looking very, very good. There is a slight bias in the map towards the T's, and here we go again. Double AWP coming in from VERYGAMES. I don't know if that money would have been better spent getting NBK another gun other than a Banners, but they're going to go double on it, and unable to get a pick through that smoke. But oh, what's happening at long here? MSL running out, getting one, getting two, spamming through the smoke, wasn't able to get a third, but they know that they've got some sort of long push, and that, again, that scrap that worked so well for them and we said was the right decision, actually is probably going to cost them the round here and cost them a 9-6 deficit at half time. But still a lot of bullets to be fired between now and then. You can see Glaive is got two kills, so sorry, it's MSL that's got two kills. Yeah, he's dead now, so Glaive is just moving into mid. Gonna get removed from the round by Smiths. Nilla just jumping across the gap to force that missed AWP shot from Kenny S. Nilla gonna get a safe plant. Might play a factor in into this round. We'll see if that's gonna be a problem. But they're flashing, they're smoking. VERYGAMES are looking to just coordinate the push. It needs to be coordinated to perfection. Nice little shoulder pick from Smith. Going to allow him to get in. Where Smith is going to get the kill. Nilla's going to answer back. Nilla has just gone ridiculous to make it 9-6. What on earth just happened there?
Yeah, that was so back and forth. First, I thought ANEXIS would have that round easily. Then Kenios came around and turned it getting two frags. And then somehow Nilla managed to get three frags and winning the round for ANEXIS.
Well, I couldn't even keep up with the crosshair. I mean, obviously, I'm older than everyone else here, and probably older than everyone else in esports, apart from Sir Scoots.
Good
but
job from
my eyes couldn't keep up.
Good job from MSL that round. I like their strategy there. When MSL, he just ran out long and probably had the best spawn, and they had two guys in A house just throwing nades over the roof, like support grenades for one player. It's kind of risky because it's only one guy, and they can like luckily get him through a smoke or something. But this time it definitely paid off. MSL got the two entry frags.
Right, so as we've done when we've been casting together, and a game is poised on a knife edge and worth talking about, predictions. How do you see this one going?
I think VERYGAMES will win.
Okay, so you're going to think VERYGAMES is going to win. I'm going to stay true to my prediction and say ANEXIS are going to nick it. I think they've got the sharper aim, it seems to be at the moment. But we should wait and see. And there's a huge pistol round coming in here. And it is first blood to ANEXIS. They've rushed on to B here, VERYGAMES. It's not going to work out in their favour. You can see that someone's gone delayed. And MSL went delayed and read it well. But screaming Kenny S. And it's another team kill for Kenny S. I thought Kenny S had got a kill. No, it was a team kill. So comedy VERYGAMES. Lads, it's not the time for comedy now. You're going to go home if you keep up these team kills. ANEXIS go 10-6 up. It should be 12-6 up. Surely at 12-6, there's no way back for VERYGAMES.
Well, maybe. I mean, it is T on Dust 2. I mean, basically, if they can get one or two frags on the Ecos, they're close round in the beginning and they reset their money situation, they can get, like... It's sick how fast rounds can go out your hands when you lose the economy on this map.
Well, the way I look at it is, I mean, ANEXIS certainly haven't... the game's been so close throughout, with the exception of one half on Nuke. They've made it a tit-for-tat game, ANEXIS. they could afford to lose two rounds for every one they win once they get to that 12-6 stage, and they're still going to be okay. So I just feel, on a reflection of play, that ANEXIS winning that pistol round have really played themselves into a good position here. But of course, VERYGAMES trying to do something with this eco, not a lot happening though.
But decoy grenade and see the spawn.
Yeah, another decoy grenade. We're on decoy watch here at Face It. We do like a good decoy. MSL just wrapping around, and there's the last two kills. That good plant, though, it's got to be said. It was a fairly successful eco round.
Yeah, for sure. I got one frag and got the bomb down. I think they were really happy about that, especially because they didn't get the plant on the pistol round, which... That plant basically makes them able to buy this round.
Yeah, so,
so
it might not be 12 rounds to 6, but yeah. It still doesn't change the point I was making, that with that kind of advantage on a map that's, you know, a slight T-bias, but pretty much balanced.
They're going for an eco.
Yeah, they are going for an eco, so 12-6 should be incoming. Right, let's talk a bit about how VERYGAMES can use the players they've got on their team to open up some bomb sites and have a very successful T half. What would you do if you were kind of the manager and you could control these players? What would you recommend?
Well, I would give Kenny S an op, play pretty slow, and like if ANEXIS is playing defensively A, I would go for a B split. If they are playing aggressive short, I would just send like good aimers like Screaming Smith. Go short and just try to kill them. We can support you with grenades.
Okay. So there you go. That's what threat would do. Maybe you should go into management.
Yeah, maybe.
I think that could be the future. Casting manager. He can do it all. And certainly he's been enlightening me with his tactical views about this. The only thing he really has got wrong with that. But we can see that the eco is coming in, and it's pretty much straight butchery for those pharmacists on burst fire. Glaive having a nice little round, but VERYGAMES again have done incredibly well to get a plant here. I've got no doubt ANEXIS will go on to win this round. You can see Glaive picks up another kill to make it a four-man for him. And, well, there we go. Two good plants. That's going to really give VERYGAMES a good financial platform moving into these must-win rounds.
Yeah, for sure. And kind of a bad anti-ecos from ANEXIS, but it's worth mentioning that CT Dust 2 is probably the hardest anti-eco to win flawlessly.
Why
it's
is
not
that?
Because there's not many choke points. It's on nuke, you have like ramp and hut, like small choke points. This is wider. Wider areas like long, like actually short is quite wider than 1.6 in this game as well. So due to this, they can actually be forced to an eco now on ANEXIS if they lose this.
Well, we will see what's happening, and as expected, very slow round because VERYGAMES need to ascertain some information moving forward. They've got an uphill struggle. They're 12-6 down. And even though they're on the more favourable side of the map, they are fighting for their lives in this tournament. And it would be hugely disappointing for them if they weren't to make it through. Especially at the hands of a team like ANEXIS, who, again, nobody really talked about ANEXIS being potential finalists. Everyone talked about Na'Vi, everyone talked about ESE, everyone talked about VERYGAMES. No one was talking about VERYDAMES, I guess you would have to say. These guys are playing brilliantly. So.
And they're going for a four guys on short now. But a Pimps is in a really good position if they decide to push the A right now.
Well, I think Glaive, and again, it's a dual op setup. Glaive is just going to be looking around, scoping. So he's going to be like, look, man, the coast is clear. They've only got 30 seconds. And it's go, go, gadget. Distance. He's going to get two kills by pushing up there. And, well, it's going to have to be a case of, yeah, Kenny S just jumping around and scoping him. This round is over. And in a way, I'd say ANEXIS were very slow to react to what VERYGAMES were doing. And they just gave VERYGAMES a nice and easy plant. ANEXIS here definitely going to save their guns. They know they've got rounds to play with. So it was very tactically well executed. They didn't lose a single man, VERYGAMES. But ANEXIS seemed to be a little bit slow to kind of read the situation.
Yeah, for sure. And it seems like it's some kind of new standard thing to do when you have short as terrorists, that you jump down one or two players in CT spawn.
Yeah, I don't understand that.
Yeah, and it seems to be really effective. However, I feel it can be very easily countered with having one guy in CT spawn.
Yeah, of course. Yeah.
I mean, because he can just go and backstab them right away. So what I would like to see from ANEXIS is, if they know that VERYGAMES is on the short, they should just... Maybe Pimps, instead of being on the bomb site, he could go down in a CT spawn and try to kill those two guys jumping down there.
Well, it's definitely been working out that round for VERYGAMES, but they've still got lots to do. And you can see that with these guns saved, it's going to be an eco. Apart from the guys who've got the guns, and well, there was some sort of headshot, I think, coming through a door there. That was a horrible crunching sound to take Glaive down at 54 HP. And Nilla has got the rifle. MSL's on peak patrol at long. Rest of the guys just armed with pistols and just waiting for a peak. But VERYGAMES aren't going to do anything stupid here. Been in this situation so many times, having to battle back and against against teams who are in more favourable positions. And they're not going to run into an eco setup like noobs. That's definitely not going to happen. So the Nexus haven't been fortunate in that sense, that VERYGAMES have had a lapse of concentration. But as the VERYGAMES push out a mid, they are going to run into a couple of people. Nico really needs to make this count, and in the end, he doesn't. Scream's going to pick up some kills. Existence is going to pick up another one. This eco not really going the way that they'd want it to. Pimp's able to get a kill, but he's down to 4 HP. So even if he picked up a gun, I don't think he'd be doing much with it. MSL, though, with a great little quick AWP. And it's 1v3. He's going to run away with that AWP. He's doing the right thing. He's going to save that for his teammates. And that's going to be another round to VERYGAMES. It's 12 rounds, 2-8.
Yeah, and they actually got their economy going now. I don't think they like that much that the MSL is saving his AWP, because VERYGAMES know if they're going to get back into this game, they have to play the economy game, forcing ANEXIS to many ecos. But this is a start, at least.
Well, it's like you say, it's amazing how quick those rounds disappear, because, you know, 12-8, oh, it's still an advantage, but you lose the next two, it's 12-10, and it's pretty much a tie game at that point, especially when you take into account that losing a round in a close game pretty much is going to force an eco at some point. VERYGAMES probably is financially superior at the moment, and you can see ANEXIS, even though they lost that round but did save and did eco, they're still having to drop guns, so losing this round could be disastrous for ANEXIS.
Yeah, for sure. Basically, if you're low on money on a CT, it's when you lose one round, you lose two rounds.
Yeah.
So you can take the lead ANEXIS had and divide it by two. That's how many rounds VERYGAMES need to win.
Well, that's what I was saying in my inarticulate style earlier. That I didn't think ANEXIS could surrender that lead, but at the moment, the ratio is going to be in VERYGAMES' favor unless they turn that around. And it is another slow build-up. VERYGAMES are getting their brains on. They're trying to think about this methodically, and that's real loose play from Pimp. He got baited in for the kill on short, and that's going to mean that VERYGAMES are able to get that kill nice and easy and then push out a short. And once again, you can see someone dropping down into CT spawn, which is going to leave A open. This is going to do it, and he's going to get some kills here. Surely, no, he isn't actually. ANEXIS is going to answer back. Don't think his aim had reset. Nico's going to get a kill as well while all that was kicking off. But Scream, in the meantime, has made it onto the B bomb site. He's going to get one kill through the window on B bomb site. Kenny S is now coming in. He's going to flash over the top and smoke off it. So he's going to get an easy plant. No, he's decided he's going to throw it down, and he's going to use his AWP to try and stop anyone who peeks through that little window gap while Scream goes for the plant. So it's a 3v3 situation. Very tense. Scream's going to put down a fake plant. He's going to be watching the doors. They're expecting the push to come in. ANEXIS, good discipline. They're waiting to hear the plant. They're waiting to hear the beeps. Here come the flashes. But in the end, Scream able to get one. Wasn't able to get two because he's run out of bullets. And that's going to allow Nico to get an AWP kill. Scream's going to get a pistol kill, though. And that's going to play right into the hands of VERYGAMES. And MBK is going to mop it up and take down Nico at the last. And they've held their nerve to make it 12 rounds to 9. And as you said, Bjorn, I think economically speaking, we're now going to see another eco for ANEXIS.
Yeah, so two rounds for each weapon round they win. That's a very, very effective way to play. It just shows how I think Dust 2 is like the hardest map I see for this. It's so easy to get in a bad situation with economy. And it was this map, I remember, MTW sometimes tripled eco because they didn't want to get in this situation that ANEXIS is in right now.
So VERYGAMES just mowing down the Danes at the moment, just finding it very easy. And I'll tell you this, VERYGAMES right back in this. It's going to be 12-10. Next round, pivotal in the game, because you feel if ANEXIS lose it, we're going to see a tie game. All that momentum with VERYGAMES, all that money in the bank, the French will be loving it. And it's why you can never count them out. They have got that pedigree of champions. But ANEXIS, They're not out of it either by any stretch of the imagination. Got some great young aimers, some great young talent. They've got a core team that's been together for a long time. They've got players capable of all sorts. So ANEXIS really need to just get that momentum back, get that belief back. But it's going to be incredibly hard when VERYGAMES are pinning them and not even letting them save guns. And there it is, 12 to 10. So vital bio round coming in. What do you think we'll see from ANEXIS here? Are they going to maybe try an aggressive strat? Well, no, they've gone for a dual AWP setup. What do you think of that? Do you think that's the right decision or the wrong decision to make it this time?
I think it's the wrong decision. I think they should try buying M4s and just trying to be aggressive and saving some money so they're not forced to eco every single round.
Interestingly enough, you talked about aggression. Here we go. We're going aggressive on short, but we're going aggressive with the AWP. Brilliantly executed. Well played from Nico with that, like, double boost to get up short and get that fast kill in lower. And that's exactly what ANEXIS needed. So it's all about these next kills now. Do not throw that lead away, is what they will be saying. Do not give VERYGAMES the next kill.
And this is a sign of a really, really high-level team. Going for that early pick on the short, and then totally rotating back and pushing three guys long, going for a defensive defensive A positions as they're doing right now.
Absolutely.
Great play from ANEXIS.
Well, it just goes to show, I mean, we've not really given them a lot of credit for tactics, but clearly they have got brains in their heads. They know how this game works, and they are capable of doing some amazing strats there. And that's one of the most kind of almost like exciting things I've seen sort of happen from any of the teams here, to do that little pick, and then, as you said, to drop back to long. Existence has been cut down now to 9 HP. This round looking very good for ANEXIS, but we know how these rounds can turn, you know, just like that. Flip of a coin, a moment, anything can happen. Two kills, especially when you've got the players that we've got on this server. So 25 seconds coming up on the clock. VERYGAMES are going to have to commit to a bombsite. They're going to have to do something very, very special. That bombsite is going to be B. And that runs straight into an AWP. Glaive's there. Nilla playing close, he's going to get two. Existence is the man bringing up the rear with only 9 HP. And there he goes, he is down. So ANEXIS are going to be feeling supremely confident with the way that round went. A beautiful strat, executed to perfection to make it 13 to 10.
And I cannot express how important it was that they won that flawlessly. It's basically that could have won them the game. And like the decision that Nilla decided to just rush himself at the end of that round, he managed to get the kill, but that could have been very costly for the team, losing a weapon at this time in the game.
Well, ANEXIS have certainly took a lot of damage there. We saw Kenny S getting another tag through those doors. One of the few players that seems to do it with any frequency at the moment in this game. Certainly it isn't how it used to be, where the battle of mid and just two between AWPers reigned supreme. But VERYGAMES know that they absolutely, positively need to win this round now. Otherwise, they are going to face a horrible uphill slog. Not what they want in the stages in this game. And obviously, ANEXIS still got those AWPs. Still doing that dual AWP setup. So, you feel Zentikill, that's a jumping headshot from Nilla. So, so mad when that happens. Kenny S taken down. Smith is going to get the revenge frag and answer back. So it's a trade. It's 4v4. You can see that they're pushing him. Pimps on Goose. He's going to get a kill. And VERYGAMES are going to have to back out of this. And you can see actually that was a bit of a fake there. They were just trying to get into an advantageous position on A. That leaves Pimp tucked away on Goose. Glaive still on B bombsite, just looking around, waiting for someone to push tunnels. And Existence is the guy who's next going to be going on the way. Waiting for Pimp to show himself. Won the battle of. And here's the plant going down. MBK going to do a safe plant behind these boxes. Probably knows that there's one of the players, one of the ANEXIS players at long. Screaming this lower tunnel, just waiting. He's going to get one. He's going to shut down this rotate. And I'll tell you what, they've played it to perfection again, VERYGAMES. They are going to win this round. Nico probably is going to be forced to save. And this round so hugely important. If VERYGAMES had lost this, they've given 14 rounds to ANEXIS, probably on an eco. And you can see Scream taking down Nico with a nice crisp headshot. 13-11 to ANEXIS. VERYGAMES clinging on.
Yeah, great play from VERYGAMES right there. And that's one. Yesterday we didn't see that good communication between them, but this time they timed it out perfectly. Scream going inside at B bomb site, and the other guys just walking up the short, knowing that there was going to be a rotation, and Pimps just ran into their crosser because he thought it was a B attack.
Well, looks like we've got the old four pistols and Mag 7 mix that we've seen from ANEXIS a few times. MSL's going to put that Mag 7 to use and get an AWP out of it. Kenny F probably shouldn't have been so aggressive, but in the end it's not going to matter because MBK is going to rip his head clean off before he has a chance to use that AWP. He's going to pick up another one as well. Smith's going to pick up another one. They're all over a bombsite for every game. They are going to win this round, barring something incredible from Nico. I don't think we're going to see it. And Nico has managed to pick up that AWP, and that could be important. So Nico is going to drop back and just try and save this AWP while VERYGAMES are going to be on the hunt. They know that that AWP is loose. It's going to be in the wind. Nico's going to get a quick kill there. Play for the exits, but you can see Existence just wrapping around. Back to T-Spawn. Going to be heading straight towards Nico. Nico's going to have his wits about him here because he's about to get crab clawed. Scream's going to get the kill. Nico unable to save the AWP. Yeah. 13 for 12. Ah, wow. I tell you, close, close game.
Yeah, absolutely. And it's like late game on Dust 2, hunting weapons can actually be like match deciding. So you could actually see how every single VERYGAMES player just ran with a knife. They knew that it's so important that they didn't get that AWP.
And just looking at the frag chart, you can see it's Smith who's actually jumped to the top. So Smith's had a great game in this best of three, 20 for 19. It is 20 for 18, sorry. And you can also see as well Nilla at the top on 16 for 14. So this game really poisoned the knife edge, an even distribution of frags across both teams. Existence is going to get that first kill. He's going to get pegged back almost immediately. And Nico with a big, big AWP frag there on Kenny S. So starting to win that duel again, that duel that we felt might be important when we highlighted it at the start of the game. But MBK is going to use those barrels to kind of just bunny hop across impromptu style. And Pimp is hiding in the pit. VERYGAMES all over that bombsite. Really needs to do something here. Really has to get a headshot and use that position to his advantage, and does. Takes down MBK from long, and that's going to allow the people to rotate from CD spawn, but they're rotating straight into Scream. That's the one place you don't want to do. Pimp's having to come up. He needs to take out Scream, and does, and there's two kills there. Glaive's going to get another one, and that means they're going to be able to get this defuse. It's going to be 14-12 now. Two headshots. Just incredible play from ANEXIS. Oh, wow. I tell you, for a minute, it looked like they weren't going to get that, like Scream was going to clear up, but ANEXIS have done it.
Yeah, great game. Both teams showing really great stuff. I mean, VERYGAMES tried that strategy when they're just throwing a lot of nades for Existence. He just jumps into the big pit. ANEXIS knew perfectly how to counter that with throwing Flash down in the big pit, rushing towards him, and Pimps was able to get in that advantageous position you were talking about.
Well, they talk about a Pyrrhic victory. They've had to buy pharmacies, so their money not in a good state by any means. So it's rifles versus rifles, but a full complement of AKs for VERYGAMES. ANEXIS have got two pharmacies here to go with three M4s. So even though it's 14-12 for ANEXIS and ANEXIS won that round, financially speaking, you feel that ANEXIS are kind of on the ropes in a way, but they can win this round and they can go to match point. So VERYGAMES, they are not going to underestimate the importance of this game.
Yeah, I mean, if they lose this round, it's basically 14-14, and at 14-14, they still will have little money.
Exactly,
so
exactly.
If VERYGAMES wins this round, I actually would favor them to win the match.
Well, if and
the other way around, of course.
Yeah, well, definitely, no question about that. If ANEXIS take this round, you would have to back them, although VERYGAMES aren't shy about going into overtime. We've seen that as well. So it's just so, so tense right now. You can see that we've got 40 seconds on the clock. No one's, you know, even done anything of any note. Here comes the strat, though. They're not petrified anymore. They are going to do it. Nico's going to get a kill. He's going to get another one. And Nico's going to get a third. This is huge play from Nico. Can he make it a four-man? No, he can't. Scream's going to work. No. Maybe he still can. Scream's not took him down. He's only took him down to half health. And there's a 2v3. Or 2.5, I should say. Bomb is planted. Nico's waiting for backup. He's in that spot called Gate Spot. He's going to get the boost. They're saying go for it. He is going to get that other kill. MBK is going to answer back, though. They need to play it smart here in ANEXIS. They need to face it long and not let him get into it.
Don't let them get into the...
Oh, there it is. He's going to peek and he's going to get it. So ANEXIS are going to go to match point against VERYGAMES. And I can see my fellow Scandinavian chum or Nordic chum out there. War Clown is giving it pelvic thrusts at the moment. He is feeling it for ANEXIS.
Yeah. Even though I called for VERYGAMES, I'm really rooting for ANEXIS. I mean, I want to see another final than VERYGAMES NIP. Plus, ANEXIS has really proven themselves to be a great team this tournament.
Oh, definitely. There's no doubt about that. Whichever way it goes, you can never count out VERYGAMES, but you have to feel that ANEXIS are almost there. They're almost within, you know, touching distance of a huge, huge victory. But Existence is doing all he can to stop that. And this VERYGAMES team, they're just going aggressive. They're going gung-ho. Scream's going to get a headshot. Kenny S is going to get a headshot. All of a sudden, it's 4-on-2. Nico's trying his best. What a time for him to come to life. And Nico's going to get a headshot. But B bomb site is wide open. And the bomb is going to go down. So we're going to have to see a retake here.
And they need this weapon so badly right now. I actually think VERYGAMES is, as soon as they realize they're not coming, they basically should hunt them down, like all three of them.
So, well, ANEXIS aren't going to go for it again. You're absolutely right. Great discipline. They are just going to save in the pit, which is indicative of the financial situation. Nico will be thinking, it's a shame I can't carry more than one rifle. I'd love to take some home for the boys. So VERYGAMES are going to win this round. It's going to go to 15-13.
And they should eco next round. It's a very hard decision to take because then you will only have one round to win the game, but otherwise you will have two half buys to win the game. I mean, they save two weapons. It depends if they can drop M4s, and I don't think they can.
Well,
let's see. I hear Kevlar sounds, so...
It's good that you know what Kevlar sounds like. I hear Kevlar sounds. But no, you're right. They're going to make the hard call and they're going to eco. So it's going to be two rifles, three pistols, possible 14 rounds incoming for VERYGAMES. No overtime, please, bros. Just don't do it to us.
And I actually think it's looking like overtime, or at least it's a very big
challenge. Oh, maybe not. You can see that pimp has put that M4 to good use and got a headshot on Kenny S, who's going to be hugely frustrated. I can just picture him slamming his keyboard down onto his desk from here in Italy. You can hear it all the way in Vienna. And of course, Existence is on 5 HP, so incredibly low. 45 seconds about to come up on the clock. Full complement of health and players, but not weapons. Nilla's going to get one. NBK is going to answer back. So tense. And there's Pimp with another one.
They're going
to
win.
Pimp just pulled it out of the bag for his team. Smith is doing all he can to keep his team in it. Smith and Existence is so tense. The bomb is going down. It's a 3-on-2 and barely a 2 because Existence is so low, but he has got an AK. But they've all got guns now, ANEXIS. Smith is going to get one, but they are going to win it. They are going to win it. GG, well played. ANEXIS upset the odds once again to beat VERYGAMES in the Madcatz CSGO Invitational.
Oh, no, he dropped the defuse. It was kind of...
Wait, I was going... If that had happened, that would have been mortifying. But, well, VERYGAMES had all disconnected from the server anyway, so it probably wouldn't have made much of a difference.
Yeah.